Last time, we had talked about electric current through conductors. Let us quickly revise whatever we did last time and then continue with it. So, we had talked about quantization of charge. We had talked about the drift velocity. Then, we had talked about Ohm's law, Ohm's law experiment, IV characteristics of ohmic substances, the characteristics of ohmic substances, the IV characteristic of non-ohmic substances, and the characteristics of non-ohmic substances. Now we are going to talk about the specific resistance or resistivity. Specific resistance is nothing but a resistance. Let us see what is different. At constant temperature, resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. R is directly proportional to L. More is the length, more is the resistance. Resistance is inversely proportional to the area. More is the area, less is the resistance. Combining these two, R is proportional to L upon A. Therefore, R is equal to rho L by A. We have changed proportionality to equality by introducing a constant rho, which is known as the constant of proportionality, and it is known as the specific resistance. Rho is equal to Ra upon L. Therefore, resistivity is defined as resistance per unit length per unit cross-sectional area at constant temperature. Now let us talk about the different types of resistors. Resistors are of two types, the linear and the non-linear, depending upon the characteristics. The non-linear type of resistors are thermistors, photoresistors, varistors. The linear one is divided into two types, the fixed and the variable. Example of fixed are of three types, carbon composition, carbon film, wire wound. Variable ones, examples are rheostat, potentiometer and trimmer. Now let us talk about the color coding of carbon composition resistor. This is one type of resistor. In carbon composition resistors, there are four lines like this. The first one is coded. Second is also coded, third is coded, fourth is coded. The first two represents the number, third one the multiplier, and the fourth one the tolerance. Now, for black it is 0, brown 1, red 2, orange 3, yellow 4, green 5, blue 6, violet 7, grey 8, white 9. How are we going to remember this? Just take the first letter from each one here. B, B, Roy, Great Britain, Very Good Wife. This is how it is generally studied. Now, let us take the second digit. The second digit again has the same coding, 0 to 9. The third line represents the multiplier, multiplied by 10 raised to the same coding as the first and the second. So if it is black, then it is 10 raised to 0. Similarly, brown, 10 raised to 1. And so on for all this up till white. Now the third line can also be golden or silver. The multiplier will be 10 raised to minus 1, 10 raised to minus 2. The fourth line can either be brown, red, gold, silver or no color. Depending on the tolerances, for brown it is plus minus 1%, red it is plus minus 2%, gold it is plus minus 5%, silver plus minus 10%, no color plus minus 20%. Now let us take an example. Look at this. This is a type of resistor which is commonly seen everywhere. The first line is yellow. Second one is black. Third one is orange. And the last one is golden, fourth one. So yellow stands for 4. Black, 0. Orange multiplier 10 raised to 3. Golden is plus minus 5%. So you have the value as 40 into 10 raised to 3 plus minus 5%. Now let us take the resistances, number of resistances in parallel. Now if you connect these resistances in parallel, then this current gets divided among the three resistances. I gets distributed to I1, I2, I3. But since all the three are in parallel, the voltage is constant. We can take the thing that is different, that is I. I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. According to Ohm's law, we can write I as V upon R. So V upon Rp is equal to V upon R1 plus V upon R2 plus V upon R3. Therefore, 1 upon V gets cancelled. So 1 upon Rp is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Resistances in series. Let us take a number of resistances connected in one after another. That is series connection. Now, since they are connected in series, the current is constant. Same current flows through all. But the potential difference is different. V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So, we started with the thing that is different. Again, according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. Therefore, I into RS, S stands for series, is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Therefore, RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now let us talk about electric power. Power is defined as the rate at which work is done by the electric source is called electric power. Or the rate at which energy is drawn from the electric source is called electric power. Power is equal to work upon time, that is W by T. According to the definition of potential difference is work per unit charge. So, work upon, what is charge? Charge is current into time, I into T. Therefore, W is equal to V into I into T. So, power is equal to VIT upon T. T, T gets cancelled. So, power is equal to VI. Power is measured in watt. 1 watt is, if 1 joule of work is done in 1 second, then the power is said to be of 1 watt. Thank you. We will continue with the 12th standard lectures next time.